So when you love making music, it's your passion and you want to be able to do it for a living, but you're not quite there yet. How do you allow yourself to relax, hang out with friends, family, relationships? How do you allow yourself to get enough sleep without feeling like you're going to miss an opportunity? Well, let's talk about that. What's going on, guys? Adam Ivey, AdamIvey.com. As always, I appreciate you joining me yet again for another video. Now, in this video, we're going to be reviewing another comment that came from one of you guys in the channel family on a recent video. So without further ado, let's jump into it. All right, guys. So a few months ago, I released a productivity slash time management video called 5 Ways to Be More Productive. Now, in that video, I share with you different tips and tricks and tools that I personally use to get more done in less time. So if you haven't checked out that video, I'll put a link for it in the description box below. Anyway, one of my awesome channel family members by the name of Ken Farrow left a very simplistic question straight to the point, but it really resonated with me when I read it. So I took a screenshot like I do, and I'm gonna share that with you guys because I think you're gonna find a lot of value in it. I think that you're gonna be able to resonate and relate to it. And the question is as follows. Now, Ken says, when I do relax, I feel like I'm going to miss an opportunity. So that's a question slash statement that I could personally relate to even to this day. So let me put my phone down and let's jump into it. All right, so let's break it down. As music creators, the majority of us are in some way, shape, or form entrepreneurs. We want to take that vision and turn it into a reality. The unfortunate part is that we're bombarded with videos such as Gary Vee stuff, and no disrespect to Gary. Now, I can relate to this just as much as the next guy because back in 2012, I actually met Gary. I saw him speak at an Inbound 2012 event in Boston. I bought his books. I read his books. I started hustling. I started getting less sleep. I started becoming more selfish. I started cutting off friends that were holding me back. I stopped talking to people on the phone because they were slowing me down. And then I ultimately hit burnout. I made $100,000, over $100,000 that year, but I hit burnout. I was miserable. I'd never wanted to do music again, to be quite honest with you. So what is the trade-off, right? That's when I had to take my life back. I had to give myself permission to relax. I had to give myself permission to sleep. I had to be able to rekindle those relationships that I had cut off so selfishly in the chase for money, in the chase for success, in the chase for progress. And I had to find a balance. So if you're sitting on the couch next to your significant other and you're frustrated because you can't work on whatever it is you're trying to work on, if you can't get in front of your computer to make music, if you can't go to that gig, if you can't go watch your buddy's show because you want to spend time with family, you need to be able to separate the two. Now, I get a little bit heated and I hope you guys don't mind, but this is the thing that kind of bothers me with some of this content now. It's this hustle, hustle, hustle. A lot of people actually call it hustle porn because people are getting addicted to this idea of motivation, this idea of inspiration without actually ever taking any action on it. Now, in Gary's defense, Gary's talked about this. He's changed his tune on some of this stuff and he said, none of this is relevant. None of this is useful whatsoever or valuable if a person's not taking action. In fact, it's one of the first questions that he'll ask you if you ever get face to face with them is, what are you actually doing? What is your goal? You know, I talk about this all the time. There's people that are talking about what they're doing and there's people that shut the fuck up and do it, right? So when you're thinking that you're missing opportunities, you're not. When you think that you're blowing, you know, precious time to sleep when you could be up working, well, find a balance. You can't live off of 2 hours of sleep. You can't live off of 3 hours of sleep. That's something that actually affected my health pretty badly when I was, and in fact, I'm gonna put up a screenshot. I was going through a whole lot of different things, including depression, including some health issues. This is what I look like in 2014, people. This, you go back and see this video. This is what I look like. I was miserable. I was greasy. I was overweight. I was just living the dream in one way and living a nightmare in the other. You have to be able to balance. Now, when it comes to the time management, when it comes to the productivity stuff, like I said, I'll have a video linked in the description box below, but I want you to think about this. A person can never relate to your exact situation. If you have a little brother that needs you there by his side, spend the time with him. Trust me, you don't want to be sitting in front of fucking screens and watch your siblings grow up passively and then lose that connection. That goes for parents, that goes for grandparents, that goes for friends and family that you've been friends with a long time and building new relationships as well. You know, you have these social networks, but at the end of the day, are you really networking to build a relationship with them? Or are you just like, hey, what can you do for me? What can I do for you? Because there's a whole lot of that bullshit floating around. In fact, I could probably pull up about 85 DMs from the last 2 weeks, people asking me for something in exchange for something. So does that make sense? We have to take back time and be able to allot ourselves relaxation time. We have to be able to allot ourselves health time. Take a long bath. Like my boy Superstar O, shout out to Superstar O. If you watch his Instagram stories, this motherfucker loves taking baths. And I mean that with the utmost respect, because he's one of the hardest working cats I've ever met in my life. But guess what? He has time to video game. He has time to go to car shows. He has time to sleep. And you could say, oh, well, he's already making his money. He's been doing this, man. He understands the value of balance, and any of my successful entrepreneur friends do the same. You know, I have coaches, I have mentors, I have people that I look to for guidance, that I look to help answer questions for me. I've sat on the couch before with my girlfriend watching a movie that we went and got at Redbox, and she's like, what's wrong? And I tell her honestly, I said, I need to be in the office editing a video. I need to be in my studio making some music. I need to finish that song. And then I feel like a total piece of shit because I know that that's not going to make or break where I am. I know that allotting enough time to do what I need to do and working smarter is going to get me to where I need to be. Think about this. Athletes, they go to practice and then they rest. They need X amount of rest in order, even truck drivers. There's state mandates that say that truck drivers need X amount of time off the road that they legally have to log and show authorities if they're asked. Otherwise, they can't be on the road. If a fucking truck driver needs X amount of time sleep, you do too. I'm so sick and tired of people saying, I wish there was 25 hours in a day. What, another extra hour of sleep? There's not enough time. There's plenty enough time in each day to conquer the day. Each day is a step, is a puzzle piece. If you can win the day, day after day after day, and you could set tasks for yourself that you accomplish day after day, whether that be contacting people, whether that be creating, whether that be learning, whether that be building relationships, you're going to win. Trust me. I've made more money. I've had more successes. I've had better, deeper, more meaningful relationships since I stopped working 22 hours a day, since I stopped being so selfish. You feel me? So when you feel like you're gonna miss out on an opportunity, you gotta flip the script and say, what opportunity am I giving myself? What am I giving myself? Not what am I taking away? What am I possibly losing? No. What am I doing to win the day? Get on a winning streak, as my boy Charlie says. Shout out Charlie Instagram. I'll put his information in the description box below. He's one super inspiring dude. I suggest that you follow him over there. Speaking of following, if you haven't yet, I'd love to connect with you on Instagram, and I'd love to talk about this and keep the conversation going on there. So I'll put the information up on the screen now. I just wanted this to be kind of a rant, kind of a vent, because as you could tell, I'm really passionate about this. Like, I could talk about this for another hour, but you guys would probably, I mean, the analytics is already telling me that you guys are barely getting to 50% of a lot of my videos. So if you make it to the end of the videos, I want to hear about it in the comments below. I want to hear if this is something that you've struggled with in the comments below. Let me know your number one struggle as a music creator when it comes to this. Do you feel guilty if you go to the movies with your family? Do you feel guilty if you go to sleep and you sleep 10 hours on a day you had off? Do you feel guilty if you didn't even turn your computer on for a couple days? Tell me what gets under your skin about yourself and how you're dealing with it. And if this video brought any value to you, I'd love to talk about this. So, like I said, I hope that you found value in this video. I know it was kind of just a rant. It wasn't like a how-to. I'm gonna have a whole lot of those coming up. In fact, I got a notebook right there with a lot of videos upcoming, which I'm super excited about. Shout out to everybody who has subscribed recently. And with that being said, if you haven't yet, I invite you to subscribe to the channel. If you found any value whatsoever in this video, which I hope you have, I hope that I can get a little like. Smash that like button over here. And then while you're at it, click that subscribe button. And if you wanna become a BFF, if you wanna become part of the cherished channel family, I suggest that you click that little bell icon so you can be notified first anytime I upload a video just like this. Doesn't matter if I'm in front of the screen, it doesn't matter if you're watching, it doesn't matter if we connect on Instagram, we're all in this together. That's my mission, to help you guys get further faster in your music careers, and I hope that this is gonna give you some perspective, and if anything, understand that you're not in this alone. So all my contact information, as always, will be in the description box below. Know that I'm here for you, I'd love to connect with you over on Instagram, like I said, and until next time, you could find me at adamivy.com.